Hello friends, welcome to my channel Civil Blog. In this video I will explain you the procedure of slope deflection method, which is useful for analyzing the continuous beam and frame structures. If you have not subscribed to my channel, just subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more videos and updates. So let's coming to the slope deflection method procedure. In the first step, you have to find the fixed end moments. I have already explained in the previous video how to find the fixed end moments for different loads. Different formulas I have given. If you have not watched the video, I will put the link in the description. Just watch the video of how to find the fixed end moments for each span. The first step for slope deflection method, that is to find the fixed end moments MFAB and MMBA for each span. Next, in the step number 2, you have to apply the slope deflection equation for each span. MAB is equals to MFAB plus 2EI by L into 2 theta I plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. MBA equals to MFABA plus 2EI by L into 2 theta B plus theta A minus 3 delta by L. Next, in the third step, you have to apply the equilibrium equations to find the unknowns theta A and theta B. So how many unknowns are there? We will determine by the support conditions. So in the third step, you have to apply the equilibrium equations. Then the step number 4, you have to find the final moments. These final moments, after applying equilibrium equations, you will get the unknown values theta I and theta B. This theta I, theta B, you have to substitute again in this formula. You will get the final moments. In the step number 5, you have to find the support reactions RA and RB for each span, and then you have to find out the final support reactions. Next, in the final step, you have to draw the shear force diagram based upon the support reactions values, and you have to draw the bending moment diagram. This is a procedure for slope deflection method. One example I will show you. In the step number 1, you have to find the fixed end moments. For example, if this is a continuous beam given, in the step number 1, you have to find out the fixed end moments for each span AB, BC and CD. That is MFB, AB and MFBA, MFBC and MFCB. And in the span CD, based upon the loading conditions, you have to apply the formula, fixed end moment formula, MFCD, and you have to find out and MFDC. Next, in the second step, you have to apply the slope deflection equation for each span, that is these formulas. So for each fixed end moment values, and based upon the length of the span, substitute the values in the slope deflection equation formula. Here this fixed support are there at supports A and D, so theta A, theta B value will be 0 here. For each span, you have to apply MAB, MBA, MBC and MCB, MCD and MDC. Six equations you will get in the second step. Then in the third step, you have to apply the equilibrium equations. See, step number 3, apply equilibrium equations to find the unknowns theta I, theta B. Here unknowns are theta B and theta C. So to find out this theta B and theta C, you have to apply the equilibrium equations. MBA plus MBC equals to 0, MCB plus MCD equals to 0. Here you will get 6 equations. Then again here you will get another 2 equations, equation 7 and equation 8. After solving those 2 equations, you will find the unknowns theta B and theta C. This theta B and theta C, again you substitute in the step number 2, 6 equations, that is step number 4, to find the final moments. See here, step number 4, after equilibrium equations, that is find the final moments. How you will find the final moments? This theta B and theta C values you substitute in the slope deflection equation, step number 2. Here you will get 6 equations for each span, 2 equations. Substitute the values of theta B and theta C wherever it is there. You will get the final moments, that is MAB, MBA, MBC, MCB, MCD, MDC. MFAB is fixed end moments, MAB are the final moments values. So in the next step number 5, to find the support reaction and final support reactions. To find the final to find support reactions and final support reactions, you have to separate these spans. Whereas to find out the fixed end moments, we assume every support as a fixed support. Whereas to find the support reactions, we have to divide these spans into separate A, B, B, C and C, D. Then you have to find out the R, A, R, B, R, B, R, C and R, C, R, D. How will you find R, A and R, B? By using the equilibrium conditions. Then you have to find these final support reactions. You add this R, B and this R, B value, this R, C and R, C value, you will get the final support reactions. Next, in the last step, find support reactions, then draw shear force and bending moment diagram. Then after calculation of final support reactions, you have to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. In the next video, we'll solve an example problems, different problems on indeterminate beams by using the slope deflection method. Hope you guys like this video, and if you have any comments, just comment in the comment section. Thank you.